In this video, we define equipotential lines and deduce their relationship to electric field lines. We introduce equipotentials in the context of an isolated point charge, and we follow up with an example of equipotentials between the plates of an ideal capacitor. So what is an equipotential line? An equipotential line is a contour along which the electric potential is constant. So on the left here, I've shown an isolated point charge along with its equipotential lines. So I notice a couple things here. One, the equipotential lines are concentric circles. The reason this is true is because the potential as a function of separation distance is given by kq over r for a point charge. So as long as they stay at the same value of r, the voltage is going to be the same. Well, what does it mean to stay at the same value of r? It means you're on a circular path. So these are concentric circles. The second point I notice is why I actually plotted v equals kq over r on the right-hand graph. The gaps between the circles are getting bigger as they get farther away from the charge. Another way to say it is as I approach the charge, the gaps are getting smaller and smaller. So what this represents is that equal changes in electric potential take smaller changes in separation distance to achieve. And I can see that in this two-dimensional plot on the right. If I look at equal changes in V, I'll just look at five of them. I look at the R's these correspond to. There's the first one, second one, third one. Notice that that gap is getting smaller as I approach a separation distance of zero. I'm already so piled up, I can barely even separate those last two lines. So I see those gaps getting smaller and smaller and smaller as I approach a separation distance of zero. So there's an interesting fact about equipotentials. If I imagine a charge moving along an equipotential line, so we just pick it up with tweezers and move it along this circular curve. So along this equipotential line, the potential energy is constant because if you recall, potential energy is given by charge times voltage, and by definition, this is a constant voltage or constant potential contour. Well, if the electric potential energy is staying exactly the same, then it means the electric force can't be doing any work. And that means the electric force on this charge must be pointing perpendicular to the displacement as we move it around on the curve. In other words, the electric force points radially. Well, that means the electric field points radially as well. And in fact, the electric field is always perpendicular to the equipotential lines for this reason. So this idea of equipotential lines turns out to be really useful for plotting electric fields. We just have to remember two things. And the first is that E is always perpendicular to an equipotential line. And the second is that electric field emanates from positive charges and terminates on negative ones. So we can apply this idea to the point charge and just draw the electric field lines going radially away from the point charge, because the equipotential lines are concentric around that point charge. And I know it goes away because it's a positive charge. And I know it's exactly radial because the equipotential lines are concentric. So there's what it looks like when I put the field lines in perpendicular to those equipotentials. All right, let's look at one more example that helps us to think about the relationship between equipotential lines and electric field, and also these arguments about the work done by the electric force. We're told in this example that between the plates of an ideal capacitor, the electric field is uniform. That means it always has the same magnitude in the same direction. We're also told that this capacitor has been charged to a potential difference of 5 volts. So the high voltage is where all the plus charges are gathered, and the low voltage is where the minus charges are gathered. When you're measuring voltage, it doesn't matter where you set your reference. So by convention, at the lowest voltage, we call it 0. And the potential difference here is 5 volts. I want to draw the equipotential lines between the plates for integer values of voltage, and then use the equipotential lines to graph the electric field. So the point of this example is that I have to be a little bit careful about making a work argument. So I can imagine just having a plus charge right here, and then moving it up through a displacement. So I'm moving this positive charge away from this negatively charged plate, which requires me to push upward. The electric force, of course, is pointing the opposite direction because that positive wants to go back down to the negative plate. All right, so the electric force here is definitely doing negative work. It points in the opposite direction of the displacement. And if the electric force is doing negative work, it means the potential energy is increasing Because if you recall, the work done by a conservative force is the negative of the change in potential energy. So I've got an increasing potential energy here. The second point I want to make is that it doesn't matter where I do this experiment with the positive charge. If the electric field is the same everywhere between these plates, then the work done by the electric force has got to be the same if I go through a little vertical increment anywhere between the plates. So this little plus charge has achieved some positive potential energy, and that's related to the potential at that final location by potential energy equals QV. All right, so this means no matter where I do this experiment, as long as I go through the same increment of height, I end up at the same final potential value. In other words, the equipotentials are horizontal. Furthermore, I can say that for equal vertical increments, it doesn't matter where my charge starts. I could start here and go up this far, and I would have exactly the same change in potential energy because the electric field is uniform, which means I would have the same change in electric potential. So for equal distances, I get equal changes in the electric potential. So there's my second point. An equal delta Y implies an equal delta V. So I have two points here. My equipotentials are horizontal lines. And secondly, an equal change in the Y coordinate corresponds to an equal change in the potential. So what does it all mean? It means that if I want to mark the integer voltages on the way up from 0 volts to 5 volts, I just have to divide this space into 5 equal segments. And I end up with an equipotential line at 1 volt, an equipotential line at 2 volts, an equipotential line at 3 volts, and an equipotential line at 4 volts. So that uniform electric field between the plates of an ideal capacitor, it leads to a uniform set of equipotential lines, where an equal change in height leads to an equal change in potential. Finally, we're asked to use these equipotential lines to draw the electric field. And so I know the electric field moves away from positive charges and toward negative charges, and it must cross equipotential lines at a 90 degree angle. So that's not too hard to do. Away from the plus, toward the minus, crossing each equipotential at a 90 degree angle, that's just straight down. So here's our uniform electric field. I'm trying to keep the spacing of these electric field lines constant, because the density of the field lines represents the strength of the electric field. So I've got a constant downward direction and a constant strength. If you find the physics content on Zach's Lab helpful, click on the Zach's Lab logo on the right to browse playlists and subscribe to the channel. I produce over 100 new videos per month, and subscribing is the easiest way to find new content. Thanks for watching.